everyone. This is Tim with Online Big Blue, bringing you the best in New York Giants sports talk and entertainment. Well, we've gotten some requests in the last couple days to do a video a day. So that's what we're going to do. And with the people that are stuck at home or people that are working from home have, I guess they're looking for some little entertainment besides watching the TV. And I'm glad that we can provide some of it. The first thing we want to talk about today is David Gettleman. And what is the Gettleman plan? The free agent frenzy has started, and honestly, I believe for the Giants, the free agent frenzy has ended. So with Dave Gettleman signings, the question is, what is the plan for the roster, what is the plan for the future, and what is the plan for the draft? So we're going to try to dive into the mind of David Gettleman, and that is a scary place. First thing, let's take a look at the Kyler Fackrell signing. And I probably got that name wrong, but we couldn't call the Giant press office because there was no one there to actually to confirm the exact pronunciation. Kyler started 9 games out of 61 for the Green Bay Packers. His big season was in 2018 when he had 10.5 sacks and 12 quarterback hits. Good season in 18. But the Packers thought so highly of him in 18, at the end of the 18 season, going into 19, they brought in 2 additional free agent linebackers to compete with him, and he lost his job. So last year in 19, he had only 10 quarterback hits and 1 sack. So there was a big drop off there, and I think what Gettleman is trying to do is pull a Marcus Golden and catch lightning in a bottle for a second season for Kyler. Now, the only difference is, you know, Marcus Golden had success in the James Betcher system, but he had success. Still, he had more issues with injuries at times than anything else. So the question with Kyler Fackrell is he going to fall into Marcus Golden, or is he going to be another free agent bust for Dave Gettleman? We did a whole video that basically outlined the fact that Gettleman is not very good at picking free. He's better at drafting, but not very good in free agency. So for a guy that only started 9 games out of a total of 60, potential 61, I'm not feeling the love. He is a linebacker, yes. He is a blitzing linebacker. He cannot cover. He is also not much of a tackler. His tackle totals were not very impressive. So at $4.5 million, he could be a low-end pass rusher. Low-cost pass rusher from the outside in the linebacker position. But I'm not seeing it. And with the addition of Blake Martinez, Blake is horse of a different color. He's a 2-down linebacker, and we've gone through this. We're not going to go through it again. 2-down linebacker, where most of his tackles were made 7 to 9 yards off the line of scrimmage, which means that he is stopping the running back and not delivering hits. He is preventing yardage. And he also has a lot of what we call on pylon tackles, where basically he just jumps on the pile and gets a tackle or gets an assist. So between that and Kyler, you know, I think they're trying to revamp the linebacking core that way. A lot of people are looking at Leonard Floyd saying, well, we could sign him. Well, the problem is, guys, we're almost out of cap space. You know, between these deals and, you know, bringing back, you know, Elijah Penny and a couple other players and the rollover money Gettleman needs to have and the rookie pull that Gettleman needs to have, unless he releases Antonio Bethea and saves that $3 million, we're heading towards the red, guys. So I don't see, unless we get Leonard Floyd on a cheap deal, I don't see them bringing him in. You never know. Like I said, if it's cheap, we could probably bring him in. But the problem is, if you bring in Leonard Floyd, you're probably not drafting Isaiah Simmons. So what I wanted to do is quickly just break down the offensive and defensive roster and see where Gettleman's mind is going for the rest of free agency and the draft. If we take a look at the offensive line right now, we have the left tackle, Solder, left guard, Hernandez. We have no center because John Jalapeno was not tenured. The right tackle, Mike Remmers, has gone to free agency. Looks like he's going to go over to Denver. And then we have Kevin Zeidler. Okay, so we're going to need to automatically replace 2 starters on the offensive line. And if you take a look at what's out at free agency right now, I'm not feeling the love. I'm not seeing we're getting that talent. I mean, backing up our offensive line is Slade, Nick Gates, and Spencer Pulley, and Eric Smith. Now, yeah, Spencer Pulley could probably fill in for John H., but we don't know yet. Nick Gates does have an upside, but is he going to be a full-time starter? Again, it's a question mark. Slade and Eric Smith, to me, are just backups. So, and if we also just take a look at the quarterback position, of course, we have Jones and Tanny. Well, I mean, running back, we have Barkley and, you know, Wayne Gallman right now. And then if we go to the tight ends, we have Evan Engram, which we'll see what happens. We'll have Smith. And then, you know, we had the guy we picked up from the 49ers, who's basically replacing Rhett Ellison, the 6'8 dude, but he's basically just a blocker. So you know what? I think the tight end and wide receiver position and running back, if we pick up a backup, we should be fine. But right now, it's our offensive line that's lacking the most. So that's why, in my opinion, Gettleman going defense this heavily in free agency, we're going offensive line on four. We're either going to go offensive line on four, or we're going to trade back and try to pick up a tackle. So, I mean, that seems to be where we're going. But even going over to the defense, if we take a look, besides not having an edge, we're kind of set on the defensive line. I mean, we have Lawrence Tomlinson. We're going to bring back Williams, not my favorite player, but we're bringing him back. We have O'Shane Zimenez, who's probably going to drop out of the linebacker position, go back to the end position, and hopefully we can bring Marcus Golden back on a one-year cheap deal. I doubt it, but you never know. So we really still need an edge. After all the money we spent, we still need an edge. So then we take a look at the linebacking core, and honestly, I still think the linebacking core is a mess. We have Mayo, Carter, you know, Blake Martinez, Fackler, whatever his name is, and Ryan Conley and Buchanan. Buchanan, to me, is a waste. He's got to show something. I think he's going to get cut in camp. Ryan Conley, we really can't count on right now because he's coming back from the ACL surgery. So we have to see where he's at the start of training camp. And like I said, Blake, we know Blake is going to be a two-down linebacker. You know, Kyler is going to be basically a one-down linebacker on blitz package and situations. So our start in Mayo and then Carter. Now, none of these guys outside of Conley, who we don't know if he's coming back, can cover the tight end. And I know a lot of people say, well, you know what, we'll just bring in an extra defensive back and cover the tight end. That's great, but let's say they're in I formation, go to play action to the tight end across the middle running the slant. We're not going to have an extra defensive back. So who is going to cover the tight end? And that's still an issue. That's still a glaring issue. Buchanan was brought in to cover the tight end because he knew the Betcher system, but he was horrible. So honestly, even though we spent money in the linebacking situation, we're still lacking. The only unit on the roster right now, which I feel any comfort level in, is the corners. You know, between Beal, Baker, Love, Ballantyne, Haley, you know, and now Bradbury, we got the cornerback position locked down. You know, safety, you know, we still have Peppers. So hopefully he'll come back from his injury. Michael Thomas is a good fill-in. Like I said, I think Antonio Bethea is going to go away. We have Sean Chandler as a backup. You know, we're probably going to keep Love in the safety position. I would prefer to see him slide back over to his natural position as corner. But you know what? We're you know, outside of getting some safety help, we got a pretty good unit back there. We even have Antonio Hamilton, who we should have left in Dallas. But you know what? Antonio Hamilton is a fantastic special teams player like Cody Core is. And I'm glad we re-signed Cordy Core as well. So if we take a look what Gettleman has done with the roster, yes, he's added some talent at the linebacker position and added a young veteran for our defensive secondary. But the problem is we still don't have an edge. We still don't have a cover linebacker. And we're still short a center and a right guard. I mean, we've all known all along the Giants have a lot of holes, but you know what? This is getting ridiculous. I don't like to get into free agents that we didn't sign, but Corey Littleton went to the Raiders for only $1.75 million more a year. Now, the information with Littleton was that he wanted to stay on the left coast. That was his choice. So probably the Giants weren't going to get him. But like I said, if you take a look at it, you know, Littleton would have covered all of our, you know, he would have taken care of all of our ill wills at the linebacker position. He would be able to cover. He's a three-down linebacker. He would have been the guy we needed. But you know what? That's neither here nor there. But like I said, taking a look at all this, it looks like Gettleman's plan is he's going to go offensive line in the draft and maybe come back third, fourth round and try to pick up a linebacker. And we need safety help. So, I mean, it's just one of those things that if you take a look at the roster, yeah, we have so many holes, and we didn't really fill holes that we really necessarily think we are. Like I said, Blake Martinez is going to be a two-down linebacker. He can't cover. He can't cover a bed with a blanket. You know, Kyler Fackler, again, he is not a cover linebacker. He's going to be a blitzing linebacker, so I see him being a one-down player. You know, I shouldn't even say that because you never know. If we get someone in second and long, he could come in again. So he could be a two-down player, but he's a pass rusher. And the Green Bay Packers thought so highly of him last year, they brought in two linebackers to compete with him, and he lost out. So, and again, like I said, we still need the Leonard Williams. I think they're hoping that Leonard Williams is going to have that big season as a pass rusher. I don't see it. If you take a look at his body of work, that's not what he does. So, and I know Joe Judge came in a long time ago, a couple weeks ago, and said, listen, you know what? If we can't get a premier pass rusher, we need to get a group of guys that complement each other that can generate a pass rush that way. So I honestly, I would think that Simmons would take, you know, in the draft, Simmons would take care of our ill wills again at linebacker. He can cover, he could play safety. But like I said, with the holes in the offensive line at center and right tackle, I have a feeling we're going offensive line in the draft. And I think Gettleman's going to try to pick up some players on the cheap. Because like I said, we really don't have any cap space. If he's rolling over the $20 million like he said, we re-signed the players. So our free agent frenzy is probably over unless we release Antonio Bethea. Maybe restructure Nate Solder. We did a video that we could release him and still save some money. So, I mean, but then again, you got three holes on the offensive line. So I think Gettleman's plan is going to be we are going to go offensive line in the draft, maybe even with the first two picks, and then again try to supplement the linebacker core with a late-round linebacker pick like we've done since Jerry Reese. So, I don't know. I mean, I like – the only pick I like up is James Bradbury pick, and like I said, Blake Martinez is just a two-down linebacker who can't cover the tight end. He's going to – you know, you say what you want to say about Alex Ogletree. Alex Ogletree had moments where he could cover the tight end or the running back out of the backfield. Blake Martinez can't do it. He's shown that the last 2 years. So, you know, like I said, I think Gettleman's big plan is he thinks he fixed the defense. And he's going to have, I think that's his mindset. And then he's going to go offense in the draft. And like I said, it's a scary thought because you got Simmons sitting out there. And Simmons can fix our defense. We could still get the late round, you know, not late round, but we can still do a second or third round pick on some linemen who are available. Because there are a lot of, you know, there are a lot of linemen available in the draft. Are they all quality? You never know. You could draft a guy in the first round. He could be a bust. You could draft a guy in the third round. He could be an all-pro. So we don't know. But that's where I think Gettleman's mind is right now. And again, this is Tim with Online Big Blue, bringing you the best in New York Giants sports talk and entertainment. Thanks for listening.